emphasis on both the recorded and the live session, and learning from the India's topmost educator for any medical examination, completing the TNDs, and studying on the device of our choice, and assess up to Q banks, that is 25,000 of the MCQs, and with the printed and digital notes that are being provided. And the IQS subscriptions, Prep Ladder and the Earn Academy has come together, where we get integrated clinical essentials, video lecture, Q banks, rapid revision snapshots, and dream notes with live batches, recorded sessions, Q banks of 25,000 MCQs and TNDs, and the digital and the printed notes. So, for the NEET PG category, for 24 months, it will be costing us around 36,000, that is 1500 per month. For 36 months, it will be 1250 and 1625 for 18 months. For Iconic one, it is 2438 for 2 years and 2875 for 18 months. And for 3 years, it will be 1875, costing us 58,500. And please do use code that is Muskan 10 to get 10% of the discount. Now, raise a hand feature is something new and unique to the Earn Academy, where you can raise your hand, ask your doubts, and engage into the one-on-one interaction with your favorite educators, 25,000 high-yield MCQs with latest examination pattern, detailed explanations. Now, interactive live sessions, do the polling, raise a hand, never miss the class, and get the lecture notes anytime and anywhere. Now, we'll continue the question answers that we are left with. So we'll start with the question now. ITP, that is the immunothrombocytopenic purpura, is most common, is a complication of which of the following vaccines? So that is DPT, OPV, MMR, typhoid, or the influenza. So we have read that the ITP is a common complication of which vaccine? That is the MMR. Now, chemoprophylaxis is not done for which of the following? That is the measles, TB, diphtheria, conjunctivitis. We read that there is no antiviral drug that is available for the chemoprophylaxis of the measles. So we also discussed this one. So with reference, with reference to the mumps, which of the following is true? Meningoencephalitis can precede the parotiditis. Salivary gland involvement is limited to the parotid gland. The patient is not infectious prior to the clinical parotid enlargement, and the mumps arthritis frequently leads to the infertility. So which of the following is true? Now coming to each of the options now, starting with the last one. Now mumps orchitis frequently leads to the infertility. Now mumps orchitis, if happens, it is usually unilateral, then it is bilateral. Bilateral cases are rare, and if the bilateral cases are there, then it leads to the infertility. So it frequently doesn't lead to the infertility. The patient is infectious, is prior to parotid gland enlargement. The patient is infectious. Here it is even non-infectious, is not true. Salivary gland involvement is limited to the parotid gland. Now parotid gland is commonly involved, but it is not that just parotid gland is involvement is there in the mumps. We do have the sublingual and the submandibular gland involvement. They can be also be involved. Now meningoencephalitis can precede the parotitis. This is the true statement that in the mumps meningoencephalitis can be presented before. Commonest complication of the mumps is the orchitis or the encephalitis pneumonia or the myocarditis. So commonest complication. Yes, what is the commonest complication of the mumps? Now, talking about the commonest complication of the mumps, it is epididymo orchitis as well as oophoritis, which are common complications. Now, orchitis usually occurs unilateral, and in less than 15% cases, these are the bilateral. And if they're bilateral, then rarely it may lead to the infertility. The testis is painful and tender and enlarged to several times than that of the normal size. All right. Respiratory syncytial viruses causes all except the Coryza in kids or ARDS bronchitis or the common cold. Now respiratory syncytial virus can cause all, it is also known as the chimpanzee Coryza. So it is a Coryza agent, so causing the bronchitis, common cold, but not the ARDS. Now moving to the next one, regarding the respiratory viruses, all are true except it is the most common cause of the bronchiolitis. Mumps causes the septic meningitis, measles causes the SSV, and EBV causes the pleuritis. So, which of the statement is not true? So, respiratory syncytial virus is the most common cause of bronchitis in the infants. This is true. Mumps causes a septic meningitis. This is also true. Measles causes the common complication, which is rare. But if it happens, then it is very severe. Then it is the SSPE. This is also true. EBV causes the pleuritis. EBV causes the glandular fever. And it is an oncogenic virus. EBV causes what? Glandular fever. So, which of the following is not true? Now, which of the following age pathogens adheres to the respiratory epithelium? It is the respiratory syncytial virus, influenza, parainfluenza, HPV, or the picorna virus. So, which pathogens adheres to the respiratory epithelium? So it is the influenza, it is the respiratory syncytial virus, parainfluenza, as well as what, picorna. Now coming to each one, respiratory syncytial virus is the pathogen of the lower respiratory tract, and influenza and the parainfluenza is attached to the ciliated cells of the respiratory tract, as well as the picorna virus, that is the rhinovirus, that is the which belongs to the picorna virus family, and it also attaches to the ciliated epithelial cells of the respiratory tract. All right, so the respiratory syncytial virus, influenza, parainfluenza, and the picorna. Which of the following pair is correct? That it causes the RSV, causes the bronchiolitis, or is a viral infection transmitted from the sheep? Parvovirus B19, exanthem subitum, and the HHV6, that is causing the Kaposi sarcoma. So which of the following is true? And more than one option is true in this case. So please tell me. So coming to each one, respiratory syncytial virus is the most common cause for the bronchiolitis, and this is true in the children. Off is a viral infection that is transmitted from the sheep, and it is also known as the contagious pustular dermatitis. Contagious pustular dermatitis, which is a disease of the sheep and the goat that is transmitted to humans by the contact with the animals. Parvovirus B19 is not the causative agent. For the exanthem subitum, it is a HHV6, and for the Kaposi, we have HHV8. So both A and B are correct. Organism that is causing the bronchiolitis in the infant is RSV, rhinovirus, parainfluenza, influenza, or the H influenza. In the infants, that is what is responsible, it is the RSV. Now, classical triads were congenital rubella, includes all cataract, deafness, retinal detachment, and CHD. So, which of the following is not included in the rubella? When we talked about the rubella, we remembered starting from the brain, it causes 2M, that is the microcephaly condition, microcephaly, as well as the mental retardation. Then we came to eyes. Eyes, it causes what? It causes the cataract, or it causes the retinopathy. To the eye, it causes what? The deafness, nerve deafness. To the heart, it causes the this patent ductus arteriosus, ventral septal defect, or pulmonary stenosis. So all these are true. But retinal detachment is not there. All are true about the congenital rubella, except IgG persists for more than 6 months. IgM is present at the birth. Most common anomalies are the hearing and the heart defects, and increased congenital malformation if infections after 16 weeks. So which of the following is true? Is not true. So when we talked about the rubella, now first talk about the congenital rubella syndrome, where the classical triad were appearing, and we just saw in the brain that was the 2AM, that is a mental retardation, microcephaly. Then we came to eye, which had the cataract or the retinopathy. Then we had ear, that is a nerve deafness. Then we came to the heart, that is a congenital heart disease, PDA, and the VSD, ventral septal defect. So IgM, coming to the next statement. All are true, that is not that a question is asking. The most common anomalies are the hearing and the heart defect. This is the true. IgM antibodies are present. Now, when we do the lab diagnosis for the rubella, we have detection of either IgM antibodies in the single serum sample at the birth, and the presence of the IgG bodies in the serum beyond 1 year or the age, or rising antibody titer during the Infancy. So IgG persists for more than 6 months. This is true. IgM antibody is present at the birth. This is true. This is true. And the rubella, the highest congenital malformation, is during the first trimester of the pregnancy, and they are the permanent malformation. So that is not after 16 weeks. It is the first trimester of the pregnancy. Age groups most prone to rubella is children 3 to 10 years, adolescent girls, pregnant females, or the women of the childbearing age. Yes, so age group that is most, rubella is a disease of the childhood. It is a disease of the childhood, and between that is 3 to 12 years, that is the 3 to 10 years. Now, recommended vaccination strategy for the rubella is to give first and the foremost to the women of the 15 to 49 years, or to the infants, to the children, to the adolescent girls. What is the sequence of the preference for the vaccination? Now, recommended vaccination strategy for the rubella. For the rubella, we are having the vaccination strategy where we prefer the women of the reproductive age, that is 15 to 49. Then it is the all the children between 1 to 14 years, and then infants that are more than 1 year. So preference most is the women of the reproductive age. Now, rubella, all are seen except tender lymph node in the neck, congenital infection, that is a cataract, incubation period less than 10 days, and it is an RNA virus. Now, rubella is the RNA virus. We had the mnemonic for the DNA viruses. Rest are what RNA virus. It is presented with the lymphadenopathy and the occipital, particularly the occipital lymphadenopathy. So tender lymph nodes in the neck we get. Congenital infection is there. It is a cataract, nerve deafness, and the mental retardation, microcephaly, and the heartworm. And that is next. What is the incubation less than 10 days. The incubation period for the rubella is around 2 to 3 weeks, preferably 14 days. That is similar to that of the 14 days we also had the incubation period for the typhoid. So that is rubella. Now, which of the following is a cause of the acute laryngotracheal bronchitis? It causes the H influenza. Yes, so it causes the H influenza, parainfluenza, or influenza, or the coxsackie virus, which is a cause of acute LG laryngotracheal bronchitis. We read the parainfluenza virus. We are having 1, 2, and 3, and it is the 2 which is the cause for the acute laryngotracheal bronchitis. Sometimes even 1 is also the cause, rarely, but it is the 2, that is the para influenza virus 2, that is the cause of the laryngotracheal bronchitis. Now we have the last second question, that is a male newborn patient with a PD and the cataract infection. Which of the following viruses is likely to be the cause? It is a rubella, it is a toga virus, measles, or the chickenpox. We've already seen the congenital rubella syndromes, that in the heart, that is the most common is the PDA. Then we have the pulmonary stenosis and the BST. And the cataract and the retinopathy, these are also part of the congenital rubella syndrome. Now, four small spots are seen in rubella, measles, mumps, and the chickenpox. Easy one. Now, Forstmann spots. Forshmer spots, the are the red spots. These are red patchy that are found in the soft palate in cases of the 15 to 20% of the rubella cases. But the thing is that they are not diagnosed. They are not diagnosed. Even they can be found in the scarlet fever as well as in the measles as well. So Forshmer spots we get where we get in the rubella. Apart from that, we get in the measles and we get in the scarlet fever. We get in the scarlet fever. All right, and the measles that rubella, that is also known as the German measles, for the same reason that it is the red spots or the Forshmer spots are found in 20%, and they are small red spots. So that is found where in the rubella. All right. Now we'll continue with the apps. We did the questions about the myxovirus. Now we'll do the arbovirus.